Beijing-backed Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank proposes to its board to form a $5 billion financing facility to help public and private sector entities impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. With us now for more from Jakarta is Joachim von Amsberg, Vice President for the AIIB. Good to see you, Joachim. Welcome to the program.
Good morning. Good to see you.
So what's the latest on the proposal of this crisis recovery facility and the significance of this intended focus on health crisis and the economic fallout?
Well, we realize how severely the current crisis, the COVID crisis, really hits all countries around the world in two ways. First, by creating this terrible health impact, the disease and the need to manage the medical care that is so urgent for so many people affected by the virus. Secondly, there's an economic crisis. The countries and governments have to put their economies in a deep freeze, have to constrain activity, have to lock down cities. That, of course, causes a very big negative shock on the economies. And we are created as a multilateral development bank by our member countries to help countries with their financing needs. And so we decided to create a special facility, set aside $5 billion to help our member countries to fight this crisis, both on the health side, but also on the economic side.
The Philippine government has expressed interest in drawing from this crisis recovery facility. Have you formally heard from the Philippines?
We've had discussions and we're exploring what we can do to help in the Philippines, just like in all our other member countries. And the three areas we are offering to finance in really all our member countries are first, public expenditures on the health sector, helping governments finance the emergency medical response, the testing, the diagnostics, but also the construction of emergency hospitals and the like. Secondly, helping governments with their extra spending that they need to undertake to keep really economic structures alive, keep businesses from going bankrupt, supporting people with transfer payments. So this is the second area where we're keen to support governments. And thirdly, we are happy to support private companies, typically through banks that would make credit available to companies that are sound, but are suffering from liquidity constraints during this very severe economic crisis. And so we are offering all of these three modalities to all our members, including the Philippines. We know the Philippine government is interested. We've had discussions with the Department of Finance. And we will continue to explore what is the best way to help in the Philippines. We haven't made no decision yet, but we're offering all these three modalities to our member countries.
Final point, Joachim, could you give us a timeline, duration as to when a decision would be made and the costs of the crisis recovery facility of the $5 billion, how much of that would go to the Philippines?
It's really up to the Philippine government to decide when to ask for financing and for how much financing to ask. We will respond very quickly. That means within a few weeks, we can make our financing available. This is an emergency situation, so we cannot afford to wait. But the governments have to be the ones who are deciding what action to take and whether to draw from this facility. And so we very much look forward to further discussion with the Department of Finance to find out what is the priority of the Philippine government and what type of support they need and at what time.
All right. Thank you so much for keeping us up to speed. Keep well. Joachim von Amsberg of the AIIB in Jakarta.